Absolutely. Maybe we can even create a little band in within the group and ask some other members, whoever wants to join. And
so, hello everybody. We are kind of having an experiment out here for the EPP group, but it's actually a really nice one. So, welcome.
Do you have any specific advice or anything? Any curiosity about the parliament that you would tell me as a newcomer?
Well, I guess toughness would be really important, and standing by what you believe in, because even our group is the largest, but it's going to be very difficult to reach compromise.
And for me as a newcomer, it's these negotiations and everything is brand new, so I'm still trying to find my place in all of this?
I think every MEP can make a difference, and through your contacts, through the people you know, we could also be the ones making sure that our group stays united, but that we make sure that other MEPs also are able to follow our line when necessary.
And in terms of priorities, which were your priorities 5 years ago, and have they changed?
I was very clear on my priorities, so I worked on three spheres, mainly related to the economic development, competitiveness, investments, SMEs, but entrepreneurs as well, startups, scale-ups, and also technological developments, as well as skills, mainly back home and education. But I think in the parliament it's very easy to be active on many topics, because everybody calls you, everybody wants a meeting on any topic that's dear to them. So I think staying focused on few topics and priorities would better shape you as a person to go to on certain topics, and not to kind of spread yourself on everything that's out there. So this has, at least for me, helped me a lot to stay focused. So I plan to continue kind of more or less in the same path. But how about you? What are the topics you campaigned, and what are the things you want to stand?
Well, actually, one of the things that I was campaigning in Portugal was for climate and environment. So for me, it's a big topic. I did the first carbon neutral campaign in Portugal, and then now I have to follow up on this challenge, which is to be vocal also in our group about the needs on the emergency to talk about this, and also to talk about environment and climate change as an opportunity. This one of the biggest priorities will be the reform of the European Monetary Union, and this is also a big opportunity to ensure jobs indirectly for our generation.
When we spoke about our countries, it's so interesting, because we are, you know, far apart, but just over now a little discussion, we saw a number of things that we can work together, and I think this is wonderful for our viewers to understand how the European Parliament works, because you can defend your own interests, but in the same time make sure that those interests are defended by somebody else from a country that's further away and with a language that's much different than ours. And so I think this is what makes it also so exciting and interesting, that we can find compromise.
I think about the capital, Sofia. I'm going to be in Burgas.
Yes.
In the end of the summer for a conference, so I'm going to also visit.
Good. I actually just returned from Lisbon.
Oh, okay. So, what do you want to share about Portugal?
I got reminded by the very, very warm hospitality of Portuguese people.
Do you play any instrument?
I used to play the piano, and it's something that I would love to
start. I play guitar.
Maybe we can make a pledge here to the viewers, but also to the EPP group. Let's do that. Let's make sure that in the end of these 5 years, we can have a little okay. concert, maybe with one song we can start. That would be lovely.
Absolutely. Maybe we can even create a little band in within the group and ask some other members, whoever wants to join, and we can start playing because we have 5 years.
But what's yours? What's your hobby? Do you have one? Maybe playing the guitar?
Sometimes I play the guitar, that's true. But my hobby is on a Sunday morning going to the seaside by bike whenever I have the chance to take a break. And also I cook.
Can we make, I mean, this is a lot of promises we're giving out here, but do you want that maybe we can do a Portuguese Bulgarian inspired evening for the young members?
I think it's a great idea.
So that our cooking skills could be presented to
Absolutely.
Everybody.
No, I think we can do that. Eva, thanks so much. It was a very interesting talk, and we will keep being, we are now colleagues, officially colleagues, so I'm sure we will have a very good and fresh cooperation within our group.
It was lovely to get to know you, but it's lovely that we can be colleagues and cooperating together.